In this example, here the figure shows a uniformly charged shell of radius R1 with a charge Q1. And it is also given that a point charge Q is placed at the center of the shell. And if due to electric repulsion, the shell expands from radius R1 to R2, we are required to find the work done by the electric forces that is due to repulsion in the process. Now, in this situation, we know well that whenever we are required to find the work done by electric forces, this can be directly calculated in a system by calculation of initial energy minus final energy of system. And in this situation, if we talk about the initial energy of the system, as there are only two objects, one is the point charge at the center and the other is the spherical shell, which is uniformly charged with a charge Q1. So here we can write initial energy is the self energy of charge Q plus self energy of charge Q1 plus the interaction energy of these two charges, that is Q1 multiplied by the potential due to Q at this point, or vice versa. So it can be written as Q1 multiplied by KQ by R1. So this will be KQ Q1 by R1. That is the interaction energy of these two charges. So in this situation, self energy of a point charge we cannot exactly define. We just write it as Q. And the self energy of the charge on the shell we can write as K Q1 square by 2R1 plus the interaction energy we already written K Q Q1 by R1. Now when the shell is expanded due to the repulsion of its own charge as well as due to the charge at center, and if its radius changes from R1 to R2, we can easily find out the final potential energy is SQ plus SQ1 plus the interaction energy when the radius becomes R2 will be given as KQ Q1 by R2. So this will be SQ plus KQ1 square by 2R2 plus KQ Q1 by R2. Now in this situation, from here we can easily find out the work done as UI minus UF. If we subtract these two terms, this SQ gets cancelled out and finally we are getting KQ1. You can take the common in all these terms, and inside we can write from the first term it is Q1 by 2R1 plus Q by R1 minus, from the final energy we can write Q1 by 2R2 minus Q by R2, and on simplifying the expression, this work done can be written as KQ1 Q plus Q1 by 2 multiplied by 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. That will be the answer to this problem.